I thought an interesting story was, because Brent Bozell is such a horrendous character. He's just such a disgusting, obnoxious character. He has this thing called Newsbusters, and, you know, full disclosure, he's attacked me and Newsbusters and so many times, me and Bobby and Sam, Ring of Fire, almost a regular where every so many weeks he attacks us. So I want to disclose that. That's part of why I'm saying what I'm saying. But I thought it was interesting that he's been telling these newspapers all over the country that he has a syndicated column, that he's been writing the column. And in fact, he hasn't written the column. He forced an employee to ghostwrite the columns. In one of the newspapers, who's, you know, very apologetic about it, they say, you know, we always thought the guy was kind of a creep, basically. We always thought, you know, in effect, what they're saying is we never really liked this guy, but we had him in our newspaper so we would bring balance back to our newspaper. And now Brent Bozell, I don't know if you know his background. I mean, this is, you talk about inheritance, billionaire baby. This guy was born, I mean, really on third base and told everybody he's hit a triple for his entire life. But here's this guy who is kind of the voice of the really, really ugly, ugly right wing. And come to find out, he's a fraud. You know, no other way to put it. He's telling people, I wrote these columns. He's a fraud.
This is definitely more surprising. Like when Sarah Palin wrote a book, right? I think we all knew she didn't really write the book.
Yeah.
But with Brent Bozell, who's presumably kind of like a scholar of media, or at least he frames himself as such, it's really a bigger deal when writing and analysis is a much bigger part of who he is, to find out he's not really been doing the writing.
Yeah. Well, you know what, Brent Bozell, if you go back and watch the rise of his career, it was, if you can really call it that, I mean, basically daddy gave him a bunch of, you know, $1 billion and he spent it any way he wants to. And he's tried to build this image that he is the new Buckley. You know, that's really what he's tried to do. You know, this very bright intellectual, which obviously, you know, is something that he wants the American public to believe, but it comes to find out he's a fraud. The bright intellectual, now we find out his columns are being written by a ghostwriter. And I thought the real zinger on this was one of the themes that he uses constantly is that journalists are lazy. Journalists are lazy, and they really never develop the news.